It makes you put your lips on your
teeth.
We
are having fun.
Right? Mm-hmm. That is Uptown Funk. Mark Ronson, Bruno Mars there, and Mark is with us in the studio. What's up, bro?
How are you doing?
I'm good, man.
So exciting to hear on the radio for the first time.
So that's cool, crazy. Right?
The These day. Headphones just amazing.
That track is just, it stands out. That it's got some throwback flavor to it. It's got some contemporary flavor to it. But, man, does it stand out.
Great. That's what we wanted to do, you know?
Was it so that's you and Bruno on that track. Were you guys friendly before you started working together?
Yeah. So, well actually, we kind of met Bruno when he started to work on his second album, said that he wanted to work together. And we got in the studio and then we ended up working on Locked Out of Heaven and Gorilla Moonshine. And then when I started making my record, I played him some early demos I had and, you know, I knew that I wanted him on it. Partly because he's the world's biggest male pop star that never hurts, but and we did that song, and you know that song took a lot of work. It's, you know, it took like 7 months of chasing around the world on tour and a lot of blood, sweat, and tears. But I'm very proud of it. I love it. It's one of my favorite.
Oh, because he was traveling the world, and you were trying to get it done.
Oh man, I'd go like pick up a bass in New York, go to Toronto, like go and follow him to Vancouver, anything to get it done. And
wow.
it's kind of all like I think the proof is in the pudding, if I can say that.
No, it's a sick song. It's a
what
sick
a
song.
Journey.
Did you set out to give us some of that throwback flavor that we hear in it?
I think we all love like the James Brown and Prince and the time and wanted to kind of bring that to now.
Yeah.
You know, and I'm a massive fan of that. And I think that Bruno just, you know, with the lyrics and the vocal delivery, like he makes it, you know, so it's not too throwbacky. And I guess I love all those things. I love live instruments. I love horns, but I also love DJing and playing records in the club that sound amazing. So trying to make kind of, you know, the hybrid of all those things.
It's a great, is the whole album like that, or is it a little bit of everything?
It's definitely in that vein. It's definitely heavy on the funk.
So will you be back with more of your tracks?
I hope
on
so,
the radio?
If you'll have me.
By the way, don't mind that creature that's crawling underneath your stool.
I love her.
My dog is with us today.
Georgia.
Yeah.
She's amazing.
She's pretty
puppy.
Beautiful.
It's bring your lab to work day.
Yeah.
So she's he was very poised, though. Georgia's like crawling underneath his legs, breathing
she
on the back of his knees.
I have a studio dog as well, so I'm used to dogs between my legs.
You know, I'm so used to a dog between my legs that I don't even feel it sometimes.
I know. She's I don't just know if part that's good of in real the studio.
all right, so you and Bruno, you're going to perform on SNL.
Yes.
When are you doing that?
That's November 22nd, and I've watched that show probably every episode since I was 12 years old, so I can't believe we're going to be on it.
Have you ever been to the set?
Yeah, I think I went like a really long time ago. It was Luther Vandross and Ted Danson. So if you can imagine, like,
a minute ago.
I think I was four. And it's such a, you know, that 30 Rock building. It's just it's classic, legendary. So
essentially,
I can't wait.
It's so good. All right, we're going to come back with Mark Ronson. We're going to chat a little bit more, talk more about the music, and I think we should play ball in the air with him.
Yeah, definitely.
He seems like a kind of guy that would do well at ball in the air.
I believe so. Okay. What do you think, Mark? Are you game?
Okay, I'll do it.
He's like, I'll do anything for this record, even if you humiliate me.
He's got finesse with his.
Yeah, I know. It's because he's got long fingers.
So are you married? Single? Wow. What's going on these days?
Oh, Ryan.
Sorry, Georgia.
Georgia got scared on that one. Okay. J-Lo?
Yes.